Why is it important for you to be here tonight and help celebrate BBC Films?
Well, I think two out of the 11 movies I've done so far have been with BBC Films, and you know, I'm a big fan of the things they do where they kind of support, you know, the smaller movies that are more difficult to get made, and maybe the movies that would be hard to get made in Hollywood. I think that's what we as Brits do quite well, so yeah.
What's the value of those smaller films? What do you think they give audiences they perhaps don't get from mainstream blockbuster fare in general?
You know, I don't know. I think you often get a wider range of stories and more unique filmmaking maybe sometimes. Hollywood's always so kind of dreadful at taking risks, whereas, you know, BBC does that very well. Yeah.
You're working on some great projects coming up. I mean, starting with Stonewall, obviously a film about a very important issue. Can you talk a little bit about that and how special it feels to be involved?
Sure. Stonewall's all about the 1969 gay rights riots in New York. Which is a subject that I certainly didn't know a huge amount about, but one that's, you know, so important to such a large sort of percentage of the population. So yeah, you know, I think it's a really important film. It felt like something important while we were making it. So yeah, I hope it works.
For people who aren't familiar with the history, can you just tell us a little bit about it and where your character in the film specifically fits into that event?
Sure. I mean, it's all based on real events. A lot of the characters are real. I play the central character, who is actually a fictitious character. He's the idea is he gets caught. You know, he is gay, and grows up in middle America at a time when it was totally unacceptable, and gets kicked out of his house. Goes to New York as he hears that's the one place where it is more accepted, and only to discover that things aren't quite that simple. And yeah, so it's a very deep and moving story, I hope. Yep.
Talking about emotional, obviously we had a good chat about Fallen the other day. We're still so very excited about it. Can you talk a bit about Scott, I guess, particularly as a director, and what that experience has been like?
Sure. I mean, Scott Hicks is, you know, he's just a wonderful drama director. So in no way did it feel like we were shooting a teen movie. It felt like we were shooting a real proper drama, which is really cool.
You've spoken before a little bit about the visuals of it. Can you just talk a bit about that again? You know, in terms of, I mean, because it's quite a dark visual, I guess.
Yes, yeah, it is. I guess it's. I don't want to talk too much because I haven't actually seen the finished product. But from the last thing I saw, it looked pretty cool. Yeah.
I guess, I mean, obviously you've had an astonishing last couple of years working with people like Steven Spielberg and some fantastic actors in front of the camera. Who do you feel you've learnt the most from personally?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I've learned a lot from the actors that I've worked with just by watching them. You know, getting to share a role with Colin Firth, maybe. That was a pretty steep learning curve, that. Yeah.
Right. You got a message for fans before you leave us?
Message for fans. Keep watching for this year, because, I think Fallen should be quite exciting, so look out for that.